Saul, A Silver Ship's Novel by S. H. Jucha, narrated by Grover Gardner. Chapter 1. Jodlin crawled on her hands and knees through the air shaft, the cool rush of air chilling her thin body, making her shiver despite the exertion. The circular 1 meter diameter metal ventilation shaft nested inside the walls of the enormous spoke, extending 100 meters from the space station's core through the inner wheel to the outer wheel. A fine layer of dust coated the inside of the shaft, making it easier for Jodlin's wrapped hands and knees to slide along. 2 years ago, at the age of 11, Jodlin became an orphan. The United Earth, UE, militia caught her parents running supplies for the station's rebels. Judged guilty, they received life sentences to work the ore borers in the asteroid fields. Word reached Jodlin that her parents weren't even granted the small favor of working at the same outpost. Rather than be taken into the militia's custody and shipped via freighter to an inner-world UE-run orphanage, Jodlin ran away. While the militia searched for her, she discovered an air vent in a utility corridor's bulkhead that was detached at the bottom. The vent swung up to accommodate her small frame, and she crawled into the dark, sliding down the passages until she lost her way. In the pitch black, with the air cooling her body, Jodlin sat absolutely still, knees drawn to her chest for warmth, trying not to cry and listening to the militia call back and forth as they searched for her. Hours passed, and she sipped water and chewed on meal bars, fighting the urge to pee. After what seemed like an eternity to Jodlin, a voice hissed at her from the darkness.
"You gonna sit there all day, or you wanna come with me?"
Jodlin hadn't seen anyone, but she heard scuffling, and then saw a small glow light shining on a scrawny butt, which began fading away. Stuffing her water jug and a half-eaten meal bar into her pack, Jodlin had scurried after the fading light. Today, Jodlin was still following the slender flanks of Edmus, the boy who had found her that day. The flick light pinned in her hair fluoresced the bands of reflective cloth affixed to Edmus's coveralls and the dashes smeared on the walls, which the young rebels used to guide them through the station's extensive ventilation system. Jodlin's heart was thumping in her chest. Edmus had picked her for the raid, and it was to be her first. Her teenage mind spun fantasies of being with Edmus, who was 2 years her senior and the leader of the tunnel rats. She touched the gun strapped to her thigh for the 100th time. The tunnel rats lived to harass the UE militia, crawling through the ventilation system from the inner ring to the outer ring, to pop out and ambush militia patrols. They tagged the troopers' visors with their pellet guns, blinding them, and then swiped their stun sticks and anything else that could be grabbed before dashing back into the air tunnels. Jodlin had practiced incessantly with her pistol in every stance and from every position she could imagine until she was considered one of the best shots among the rats. At the end of the air vent, Edmus eased open the cover whose bottom was unattached. The vent ended in a utility corridor rather than the station's main passenger corridor. Edmus motioned Jodlin up beside him, and they lay together for warmth in the air vent's mouth, listening for the footfalls of militia boots. Sometime later, a nudge in Jodlin's ribs woke her, and a dusty hand covered her mouth. She flushed with embarrassment that she had fallen asleep, but Edmus's body had been a warm blanket after the seemingly interminable crawl through the incessant stream of cool air. Edmus held a finger to his lips, which Jodlin could barely discern in the dim light that penetrated the vent's slats, and he signaled her to crawl deeper into the vent. Jodlin wriggled backward as quickly and silently as she could, hearing the muffled sounds of Edmus following her. He had no sooner spread an old piece of dirty cloth over their heads to conceal them than a powerful light played off the tunnel's walls as the militia patrol sought to catch any tunnel rats off guard. Seconds later, the light switched off, but Edmus...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.